Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal and I welcome you to this another beautiful session on success stories of RBI. Today I have Manohar Taktani with me. He's had a very modest background, if you like to call it non-IITs and non-IIMs background. He did his BCom pass and then after that he's done his MBA from a very modest college. He's worked in the banking sector for 5 years, and while he was working in the banking sector, he's prepared for RBI and successfully cleared RBI in his third attempt. He prepared for RBI and gave RBI attempts in the year 2017, 2018, and finally in 2019, he cleared RBI. So Manohar, you've been staying in Mumbai for quite some time and on studying online along with your job. So how did you make sure that you could study online and yet stay away from the dangerous impacts of social media? Because I see a lot of students spending tons of time on social media, arguing with each other, trying to come out with theories of what the examination is going to be like. Random talks keep going on. How did you make sure that you were not a part of those areas?
Starting with that, working in Mumbai, so Mumbai makes you efficient. This city does not give you time, and when you have lesser time and you have to accomplish things, you become efficient automatically. So I knew that as a working candidate, I had lesser amount of time. This is one resource which was scarce to me. So I had to ensure ki main kuch bhi extra time to waste nahi kar sakta. So while I was traveling in a local train also, I was standing and studying on my phone. So I logged out of Facebook, Instagram. I left all these social media accounts. Only one account which I was using was Telegram. And that also because you get a lot of free material from there. But you should limit your usage up to that only. You should very smartly use it. Ki haan, ye char cheeze important hai. You download those resources from there. You see that discussion. Whenever there's any futile discussion going on, you just switch off the app and just move out of it. So that is what I was doing. I was not participating actively in that. My entire focus was that I would just not miss on the important resources, or if someone was conducting a good quality quiz, so I would try to participate and see. Or what I will do is, after the quiz is over, I would just go and see those MCQs, 50 MCQs or 20 MCQs. My job was done. So I was not wasting any extra minute on it. And I think other aspirants should also do it. Those who are serious aspirants, don't wait for the notification. Don't get into futile discussions. Just start your preparation if you want to get into RBI or any other regulatory body. Because as I already said, the success ratio is very less. If you're not serious, you will be thrown out in the first phase itself.
But when you go out and go to Telegram and try to accumulate all that stuff, all that information, all those PDFs and whatever is available, बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स के साथ प्रॉब्लम होती है कि एक्यूमुलेट तो कर लिया, वी कैन नॉट ऑर्गेनाइज इट नाउ एंड वी कैन नॉट इवन रीड इट नाउ. एक्यूमुलेशन की आदत पड़ जाती है. यू जस्ट वांट टू होल्ड ऑल दैट मटेरियल एंड यू नेवर गेट अ चांस टू एक्चुअली रीड दैट स्टफ और ऑर्गेनाइज इट. तो वो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कैसे किया?
Because so for that you need to refer to another document, which is your syllabus. So if you can use the syllabus like a blinder, so that will give you a lot of focus. Whenever you feel ki yaar बहुत ज्यादा डिस्ट्रैक्शन हो रहा है, बहुत ज्यादा एक्स्ट्रा मटेरियल एक्यूमुलेट हो गया, सो यू कैन गो बैक टू द पीडीएफ जो सिलेबस वाला, एंड यू कैन सी कि ये टॉपिक इससे रेलेवेंट है, एंड यू कैन जस्ट सॉर्ट इट आउट. एंड दिस व्हाटएवर यू आर सेइंग आई कैन कंप्लीटली अंडरस्टैंड एंड रिलेट टू इट. सो दिस टाइम यू विल हैव टू इन्वेस्ट. दो दिन पढ़ाई नहीं होगी, कोई बात नहीं, बट सॉर्ट योर डेटा फर्स्ट, क्लीन इट, जो सिलेबस है उसको आप लिंक कर लो, एंड देन यू स्टार्ट योर प्रिपरेशन. सो दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट.
You were already working. You were already working in a bank. How did you get the motivation ki yaar ye RBI ka exam likhna hai? Because that happens with a lot of people, working people. Okay, life is good. We are already earning well, doing well. Ambition ek taraf hota hai. But when you have to sacrifice so much, then a lot of people, giving up is a negative word, but they somehow feel that nahi ho raha hai to nahi ho raha hai. Let's just be at peace with what we are doing right now. How did you overcome that?
So I think there are two reasons for it. First, because RBI would have been a gradual progression for me. So as you said, ambition point of view, say it was fitting into my profile. Ki my next ambition, if I like, when I told it to my colleagues that I'm preparing for RBI, so they were also happy about it. When I told it to my boss, he was also looking at me with respect. So that kind of respect RBI commands. So that was like one reason to it.
Mm-hmm.
Another reason was every attempt I was gradually moving upwards. Like in 2017, I cleared phase one. Then 2018, I cleared both the phases and appeared for interview. So that was also giving a positive push to me. Ki yaar, last year, ek step aage aaya. Phir 18 mein interview tak gaya. Interview ke baad finally miss kiya. So then 19, I thought ki one more attempt, I deserve it and I should give this one more attempt. And 19 ka attempt, finally, I made through. So I think because it was a gradual progression rather than being an up and down thing. So that also helped.
अगर phase one में नहीं हुआ होता 17 में then
so then I might have like just given up just like you said that negative word I would have thought कि अगर phase one ही clear नहीं हो रहा तो क्यों आगे बढ़ना but because 17 का phase one clear हुआ so it gave me hope and hope is a good thing.
When you're preparing for these exams it's not just the result that matters, there's a lot of learning in the process also. That's what I feel personally, even if you know working professionals, so people otherwise also don't get through, they learn a lot of things. So what do you think are the major learnings that you have attained, you know, in the entire process of this examination in these 3 years?
Yeah, so I completely agree with you. And talking about my personal experience, I think what it teaches you is to be disciplined, to be committed to your goal, and that consistency. Because you are aiming for something which is very difficult and you know it, that the success ratio is negligible. Still, you are aiming for it, you are going for it. So it prepares you like, dusri bhi koi cheez hongi na life mein. You will go for it with the same impact. And this has actually happened with me. While I was not getting success at RBI, parallelly in my office, in my current job role, I was succeeding at whatever I was choosing. Like because I'm in a PSB, so for promotions also you have to appear for exams, and there's a lot of competition. So, because I was not like I was into that mode of preparation and I was into that kind of a discipline of studying, so I cleared my JIB, CIB in first attempt. Just because of RBI and CIB also, I chose that optional subject as central banking to create that kind of a synergy. So I cleared all those. Then my promotion exam, I scored. I got one of the highest marks and I cleared my promotions also. Again, to get an internal transfer also to a profile of your choice, again, you have to go for exams. So because I was well prepared for RBI phase one, here also they ask you reasoning, quants and similar subjects. So I aced that exam and got into the profile of my choice. So everything else was happening because of this preparation. So parallelly, as you said, it was helping me in a lot of ways. And today, like the kind of personality I have, it is completely different for what I used to be a few years back when I had not started preparing for the exam.
Definitely. So will you be looking towards another goal now?
Yeah.
Because you probably get used to you know, making goals.
I have already started thinking, as you said, you have like identified it perfectly. I have two or three things in my mind, which I would be like soon starting with. From the education perspective only, just to learn a new subjects and all. So I have a couple of things in my mind.
Okay. Something that you feel, you know, that you want to say, something that you feel is unique. Not all those things that we discussed, but something that you personally feel you have learned or I think as a
I think I not that some learning and good gyan nahi waisa, just ye ki like people try to weigh ek working aspirant ka or non-working aspirant ka, and they try to create that difference ki nahi working aspirants ko hi lete hain, and then they have this feeling ki nahi yaar ki jo non-working hai, like log just you were talking about some other candidate who has cleared and she had left her job. To मतलब लोग ये बैलेंस स्ट्राइक करने के लिए पूछते हैं कि यार जॉब के साथ करना चाहिए या जॉब के बिना करना चाहिए. सो माय पर्सनल थिंग इज दैट यू शुड डू इट ऑलवेज विद अ जॉब, क्योंकि यहाँ पे सक्सेस रेशियो कम है एंड जॉब गिव्स यू अ लॉट ऑफ कॉन्फिडेंस बिकॉज यू हैव समथिंग टू फॉल बैक ऑन. इवन इफ यू डिड नॉट क्लियर इट, यू हैव अ वेरी गुड जॉब इन योर हैंड. एंड हर साल हम लोग देख रहे हैं कोई कोर्ट केस हो जाता है. 2017 देयर वाज केरला फ्लड, 2018 देयर वाज अ कोर्ट केस, सो रिजल्ट्स वर डिक्लेयर्ड, दिस ईयर देयर वाज कोविड. सो गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम्स में यू कैन नॉट जस्ट वेट फॉर वन जॉब कि यार ये तो होने वाली है, कब होगी पता नहीं है. तो अगर कुछ है हाथ में तो उसको मत छोड़ो. दैट इज व्हाट आई थिंक एंड दैट इज व्हाट वाज इन माय माइंड व्हाइल प्रिपेयरिंग, कि मुझे एग्जाम क्रैक करना है तो जॉब के साथ ही करना है. आई वाज मैरिड आल्सो, आई हैड माय रिस्पांसिबिलिटीज, तो जॉब छोड़ना वाज नॉट ऑन माय कार्ड्स.
But so, then how do you balance? Like you balanced, but majority of us find it very difficult to balance between work, studies, and your personal life. It's like three things going together. It becomes very difficult for a lot of us. So how do you, what exactly did you do to make sure ki wo, did you have priorities? That first priority is that studies, second is work, third is personal life next 4 years.
See, so you cannot leave anything out of the three options you said, because one is your job. Every day you have to go there. If you don't work, you will have sour relationships with your boss and your colleagues, and that would like you would not be able to work properly also, and not be able to study also. So first to ye hai ki aapko apne work life mein, because say if there are 24 hours in a day and you are spending like 10 hours in your office, so it is majority of your day. So wo time to it has to be very good. So job to acche se karni hi padegi. You have to deliver at your office so that your colleagues are supporting you. You have to have that very cordial relationship with your boss, your colleagues. कि यहाँ पे तो कुछ इशू नहीं होने चाहिए, यहाँ से फुल सपोर्ट मिलना चाहिए. एंड देन यू हैव टू स्मार्टली मैनेज द टाइम वट एवर इज लेफ्ट फॉर योर स्टडीज. पर्सनल लाइफ डेफिनेटली टेक्स अ बैक सीट. सो योर फैमिली हैज़ टू बी सपोर्टिव, लाइक माय फैमिली हैज़ बीन वेरी सपोर्टिव. सो दैट इज लाइक वन थिंग विच विल हेल्प यू इन कि आपका जॉब भी सॉर्टेड रहे, एंड देन द एक्स्ट्रा टाइम विच यू गेट यू कैन यूज इट फॉर योर प्रिपरेशन वेल.
डिड यू एक्चुअली लर्न टू लिव इन द मोमेंट in this entire process? Because I can feel that. I don't know if I'm right or wrong, because when we are so much focused on the past or the future, it stresses us out and at the same time affects our performance. So managing three things means you have to be at par at all the three together. So do you feel that you have learned to live in the moment more now than before?
Yeah, so I did not think it that way, like living in the moment. You have given the right word to it. How I looked at it was ki ek na aapka area of control hota hai aur cheeze usme hoti hain which you can control, and then there are things which are out of it. So I used to look at it that way ki ye time hai jo mere haath mein hai abhi, and this is what I have done. Agar maine kal nahi padha tha, I was not in a mood, so it has passed. Now I won't punish myself कि यार तूने पूरा week waste कर दिया, तूने कल नहीं पढ़ा था. Whatever you have अभी, what is in your control, तो उसको sort कर लेते हैं, बाकी ठीक है, left right छोड़ देते हैं. So that is what you said. You gave the right word to it. That yes, in a way I was living in the moment.
What does it take to be an RBI aspirant, and how does it feel to be an RBI officer now?
So to be an aspirant, honestly, it takes nothing. You just need to fill that registration form and you can just start your journey. To be a serious RBI aspirant is something different. So form bhar ke koi bhi aspirant ban jayega. But to be that serious aspirant, you need to commit to that goal. You need to understand the need of the examination, ki exam kya mangta hai. You need to understand all the phases, phase 1, phase 2. Phase 1 mein kya important hai. Like phase 1 is an eliminator. Phase 2 is there to select you, and then finally interview to check your personality and take you in. So that is what I think. To begin with, aapko, agar aap serious aspirant ho, you understand the need of the exam, and then you start your journey. So that is how your aspiration will become. Finally, after 3 years, after clearing, and now soon I'll become an RBI officer. So it gives me immense pride. Because I have been a banker, I have around 5 years of experience in banking. I worked with both private bank as well as public sector bank. So I know what RBI is, how important a role RBI plays. I have seen the kind of respected commands. During GFC also, it was a well respected organization, the way it handled everything. So yes, I think I would be very happy in like being part of the great organization.
What do you think is special about what RBI is doing as a central bank, as any central bank, that is so different from what other banks are doing? Like, of course, there is a clear demarcation. Okay, commercial banks are doing commercial banking. At the floor level, RBI is managing all those banks and regulating them. But how do you see yourself internally as, you know, trying to not communicate, but trying to contribute towards, you know, RBI's major objectives, and also seeing yourself as satisfied in that role? Do you understand my question?
Yeah, so I got your point. What you are trying to say is जस्ट करेक्ट मी इफ आई एम रॉन्ग, व्हाट यू आर ट्राइंग टू से इज कि कमर्शियल बैंक्स अपना काम कर रहे हैं, दे आर वर्किंग इन द कमर्शियल स्पेस गिविंग सर्विसेज टू द कस्टमर्स एंड देन देयर आर अदर टाइप्स ऑफ बैंक, मर्चेंट बैंक्स आर देयर एंड देन देयर आर फॉरेन इंस्टीट्यूशंस, देन देयर आर आरआरबीस, ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ बैंक्स आर देयर एंड देन आरबीआई इज डूइंग अ डिफरेंट जॉब कंप्लीटली बिकॉज इट हैज टू रेगुलेट एंड सुपरवाइज एवरीबॉडी. सो आई थिंक इट इज अ वेरी चैलेंजिंग रोल इन द काइंड ऑफ इकोनॉमी वी हैव एंड जैसा चल रहा है हमारे यहाँ. बहुत एक बड़ा अनऑर्गेनाइज सेक्टर है फाइनेंशियल में, यू मस्ट बी अवेयर कि देर आर स्टिल देर आर लॉट ऑफ मनी लेंडर्स आउट देयर, हुंडीज चलते हैं, बहुत सारा एक अनऑर्गेनाइज इनफॉर्मल स्ट्रक्चर. और ऐसे कंट्री में स्टिल एक बैलेंस्ड इकोनॉमी चलाना एंड टू एंश्योर दैट देयर इज फाइनेंशियल स्टेबिलिटी विच इज पार्ट ऑफ द प्रीएम्बल ऑफ आरबीआई. सो आई थिंक इट इज़ अ वेरी चैलेंजिंग रोल एंड आई वुड डेफिनेटली इंजॉय टू वर्क इन सच एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. Because somebody has to do that work. You cannot just leave it कि हम market अपने आप खुद को संभाल लेगा. Because that is not going to happen. Some chaos will be created. Something, some innocent people will lose their money, which also happens now. But still, there has to be some sort of control, and RBI does that. So that is what I think would be. So
it's looking at it from a different perspective, from not from the perspective of just doing it for the sake of it. That's what I can feel.
Yeah.
Not as a job per se, but identifying the fundamental reasons behind that work that RBI is doing.
I strongly believe that it is a national duty to be part of the central bank. It is a national duty.
There's a lot of tussle between government and central bank that happens in every country.
Yeah.
Let's say tomorrow you are at the helm of RBI and there is a tussle. Then of course, the fiscal policies are always more political in nature.
Yeah.
So, how would you react in such a situation?
See, when you are at the helm of such important organizations, then you have to take strong decisions. So, you have to either think what is the larger good. So, if you have to like step down or you have to like stand against the government, just to ensure that for the larger good of the people, you are going against it, then you have to take those decisions. So I completely agree that governments would be like, you must have read that speech, which was by the ex-RBI governor. I think, sorry, not governor, deputy governor. And he said that, government's objective is like playing a T20 match. Whereas RBI's role is like playing a test match. Because we have to think about the longer stability. And the governments will be short term in nature. They know that they have to like again work for votes, say after 5 years, which is not the case with RBI. So I think that is how you need to operate.
Do you think that the reason that a lot of RBI aspirants fail and are unable to succeed is because they feel they try to achieve it just for the sake of getting a job, and they don't understand the actual objective of them working in the organization?
I think this can be one of the reasons, but definitely this is not just the only reason. Because even if you don't understand the actual objective, you don't have that kind of a passion, if you are able to plan well, have that kind of a strategy, you would be able to get through somehow. Maybe you would not enjoy the work after getting into the organization. Like now you feel that the perks are good, salary is good, and you join it without having a purpose. Then maybe after some time you would get bored of it. Or say in a couple of years, then you would want to move somewhere else because you did not have the understanding that what you are getting into. So that can be happen. That can happen. But I think from an aspirant point of view or from clearing the exam point of view, that won't create much of a problem.
Bahut important question hai. Normally, when we write the exam, whether it's RBI or any other government exam, humne first time likha, second time jaate hain, it's very difficult to identify your weaknesses and not only weaknesses, the problems in your preparation, the wrong things that you're doing, mistakes that you're making, and correct them. Critically analyze yourself. Nahi, ye galat hai. I'm doing it wrong. I need to correct this. I need to do it again altogether. Okay. Were you doing those things regularly in these 3 years, or because it was a progressive chart, toh nahi ho raha tha?
Toh iske na stages hai. पहला तो डिनायल है, मतलब हम देख आते हैं कि हमने तो ठीक किया था. फिर देन इट इज एक्सेप्टेंस, देन यू एक्सेप्ट. थोड़े दिन लगते हैं, स्कोर आ गए आप देख लेते हो, देन थोड़े दिन बाद यू एक्सेप्ट कि हाँ यार. देन व्हेन यू सेट कामली, देन यू रियलाइज कि हाँ यहाँ पे मैंने ये चीज छोड़ी थी लास्ट ईयर. सो देन यू स्टार्ट मेकिंग नोट्स कि ओके आई डिड नॉट कवर दिस, आई डिड नॉट कवर दिस, आई डिड नॉट. सो इट इज अ लॉन्ग प्रोसेस. आप जितना जल्दी एक्सेप्ट कर लोगे, यू विल बी एबल टू एनालाइज दोज मिस्टेक्स एंड मूव ऑन विथ योर प्रिपरेशन.
तो
एंड द वर्स्ट पार्ट इज कि जब आपको वो सब करने के बाद, लाइक फेस टू यू आर स्टडिंग सच इम्पॉर्टेंट कंसेप्ट, इंटरव्यू के लिए यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर, यू हैव, यू आर हैविंग ओपिनियन अबाउट वर्ल्ड टॉपिक्स, इंटरनेशनली क्या चल रहा है, डोमेस्टिकली क्या चल रहा है, एंड देन व्हेन यू मिस दैट लाइक द ड्रीम ऑफ योर्स, एंड देन अगेन फेज वन के लिए यू स्टार्ट विथ वो जीके का कैप्सूल और रेटना स्टार्ट. सो दैट इज आई थिंक द वर्स्ट ट्रांजिशन दैट यू हैव टू गो थ्रू. दैट इज द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट थिंग.
So did you see a lot of, like, you might be in touch with some other aspirants also? Because I have seen it personally that a majority of the students stay in that denial phase because they feel that they've given it before. Maine pehle mains likha hai, so I know what is to be done.
Yeah.
And they're unable to accept that there is something wrong with their method of preparation. So acceptance में कैसे जाएं, how do they?
So one thing is कि respect the recruitment process. Some people just after seeing the result they start abusing the process. कि यार ये तो exam flawed है, ये तो मतलब I know I've seen a lot of people on Telegram just after the result, like last year I also did not clear, and there were others also who did not clear. I was like, I was also sad, others also feeling the same, but then some people started like writing notes कि यार ये तो एग्जाम ही फ्लॉड है, दे डोंट हैव अ प्रॉपर चेकिंग प्रोसेस, लास्ट ईयर मेरे इंग्लिश में इतने आए थे, इस बार इतने आए हैं, मेरे ये सब्जेक्ट में इतने आए थे, स्टार्टेड कंपेयरिंग. सो रादर देन डूइंग दैट, उससे कुछ होने तो वाला नहीं है. यू फील बैड, ठीक है, यू हैव टू वेंट आउट योर एंगर, आई अंडरस्टैंड, बट इफ यू आर डूइंग इट जस्ट टू वेंट आउट योर एंगर इट्स फाइन, बट इफ इट्स इंग्रेन्ड इन योर हेड कि हाँ यार एग्जामिनेशन प्रोसेस फ्लॉड है, देन देयर इज नो पॉइंट राइटिंग इट अगेन. क्योंकि यू, इफ यू आर डिसरिस्पेक्टिंग द एग्जामिनेशन प्रोसेस, देन हाउ आर यू गोइंग टू फाइट इट एंड क्लियर इट? सो दैट इज हाउ इट इज गोइंग टू हैपन. यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट इट और मूव ऑन. यू हैव ओनली टू ऑप्शंस.
एंड दिस ईयर आल्सो इट हैज हैपेंड, इंटरव्यू में दो नंबर, तीन नंबर, चार नंबर, पीपल हैव गॉट एज लो एज 2 एंड एज हाई एज 47.
सो आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क यू, व्हाई डू यू थिंक देयर इज सच ह्यूज वेरिएशन दिस ईयर?
नोबडी नोस. योर ओपिनियन? नोबडी नोस. देयर आर थ्योरीज दैट आर कमिंग आउट.
ओके.
I think there can be no perfect theory closest to the reality, but the closest that I've come to, you know, the reason of this variation is that there is too little time with the board to decide whether a student is good or bad. So if the board is taking, let's say, 10 interviews on an average in a day, 8 to 10 interviews in a day, they have 4-5 hours of window. They don't take interviews after lunch normally.
Okay.
So in that small window they have to take so many interviews, and there's only one panel which is taking the entire set of interviews. So there's a lot of boredom which happens. So when one panel is taking interviews of 600 people, 500-600 people, then they start judging students on the face of it. 5 minutes, okay, this is how we think the student is. Okay, or the bio data is strong. 5 minutes, okay. If he's able to deliver in the first 5 minutes, I think he's good. That might be one of the reasons. We still don't know what exactly has happened, but there are some people comparing RBI and NABARD interview panels, and they're saying that NABARD panel is does not have that kind of variation because every interview is about 20 to 30 minutes. So they're spending more time with every student. That gives them enough time to understand the student's perspective also at times. Because judging someone in first 5 minutes or trying to understand the core personality of a person in 5 minutes is a very difficult task. Okay. So that's what I think personally. And of course, there are flaws in every person's personality. So one flaw might come out immediately in the first 2 minutes. And if you highlight this, something called as halo. So if you highlight it that, oh, he has such a big personality flaw, then you might give him a very low score. If you just have those 10 minutes to judge his personality. So that might be one of the reasons that, but it should not have happened, because last year also the panel was same. This year also the same panel was coming. So if there is a variation in the same panel, that means it was more of a conscious decision rather than a...
Yes. So I also think this was deliberate, in my opinion, completely as per my opinion, without any insider knowledge or anything. Because I also faced a couple of questions of this nature, where the board was trying to judge that whether I'm going to be a long-term asset for RBI or not, whether I'm appearing for other exams also. So I think this year they had very clear opinion that these are the candidates we want in and these are the candidates we want out. So they gave either very low scores or they gave very good scores. They did not give a lot of average scores, and they had this clear mindset that okay, these are the candidates we think who are right fit to come into RBI and these are not. So they sent out a message that interview is going to play an important role in your recruitment process. You cannot have that kind of a strategy ki yaar main mains mein hi itna cover kar lunga ki interview would not matter. So that is what has happened this year, according to me, after seeing scores of my fellow aspirants.
Because if you're giving somebody 4 out of 50, that means 8%.
Yeah.
Now, if somebody is judging some other person's personality, even if the personality is too bad, you would not want to give, 8% out of 100%. You would say, okay, 30% probably good, 70% probably bad, the points that I found. So if they're saying 8%, that means... But I think what they're trying to do is they're trying to compare it with what they need in RBI.
Exactly. Right? It's not a personality flaw as such. They don't think that the person's personality is flawed or that person is no good. And even the person who have got such a score should not like feel low of himself. This is what I believe. It's just that they have, as per the panel, they think that you don't have the right aptitude to be an RBI officer. Or they think that you are coming here for a short term. Maybe you are going to use the RBI as a stepping stone and move towards the next career option. So maybe they are having such an opinion of you. That does not mean that they think that you are not good at it. Maybe they think that you are overqualified, that you will not stay here for long. So that is why they don't want to take you. So that can also be one of the reasons.
So when you were preparing, your family must have been very irritated at times with your own schedule, moving away from their schedule, or completely at cross with their life. Your life must have been completely different, as you mentioned. So has it changed after the examination?
Yeah, so before the examination, my family has been very cooperative. My wife was letting go everything, whatever I was doing. Obviously, I would have been annoying her because I was completely into studies. But then she was letting go everything just to give me that mental peace ki tu padh le bhai abhi, kar le jitna karna hai. And once the results have been out, then she is like after my life now. And like she's making sure that whatever I have done in the past 2-3 years, so she is like making me compensate for it all now.
So like, what is better, listening to all that and going back to vegan?
I want to go get back to studies now. pick another course now and start studying again.
Have another goal in life. So as a matter of just appreciation, I have these small things for you that I really value in my own personal life as well. This is a book called Animal Farm by George Orwell. It's on politics and how politics can transform the entire society in a very short span of time. I'm very sure you would love to read this. This is a book by Shashi Tharoor. It's on international relations, as he normally writes on. And I'm very sure that you would love reading something like this. This is a trophy and an Echo. I'm very sure you must be using all these tech gadgets already in order to simplify your life and all those things. So this is for you. I'm very proud.
Thank you.